Over a decade after villagers in the Kalpakkam area of Tamil Nadu, India, faced a destructive tsunami, they are still fighting for their lives. A nuclear power plant in the area became a death trap during the tsunami, with several workers drowning within its walls. Today, some villagers believe that the nuclear plant is still connected with death and destruction, this time as a result of its own operations.
Due to the plant that is close by, people in that area are being diagnosed with cancer every month. 2 days ago, a 20-year-old was diagnosed with cancer. 50% of the population have thyroid problems.
Rates of cancer, birth defects, infertility, and autoimmune and neurological diseases have increased, affecting young and old alike. The Human Rights Advocacy and Research Foundation, or HRARF, works in the region to help affected local families, often by paying medical costs. For those families where the primary breadwinner has prematurely died or been incapacitated, HRARF helps with finding employment, school costs, and other day-to-day expenses. The Atomic Energy Department says that the rates of radiation are too low to cause a health effect, but Dr. Pugashendi, who runs a local clinic with HRARF's assistance, disagrees. He refers to a study by Dr. Manjula Datta, which compared the rates of diseases between villages close to the plant and those 50 kilometers away.
Their conclusions are very, very critical. She had found out that the thyroid problems are 5 times more in the proximal villages. Cancer burden is 7 times more in the proximal villages. And the mental retardation is 11 times more in the proximal villages.
Not only do people who work in the nuclear plant report health problems, but their children do too. Children like 17-year-old Lavanya, as her mother explains.
The doctor said the brain development wasn't there. They gave us no cause or reason. The doctor says that living close to the plant could be the cause. He said lots of kids have been affected in the area, and the fact that her father is working in the plant could be the reason.
Villagers say the nuclear plant has also affected the fishing conditions in the area.
10 to 15 years ago, we had a lot of rare varieties, lots of valuable fish close to the shore. Now, my sons ask me what sharks look like because they've never seen them in person, only in pictures. Because of pollution, the water is warmer and species have moved or died.
Through their work, HRARF also teaches the local community about their rights and how to organize to collectively defend their rights to clean air, water, and land. Your gifts to the mission and service of the United Church of Canada help local fishing communities like these maintain their livelihoods and their lives. Thank you, and please continue to give.